We return to talk about the state of race relations in America, what we've learned from the Eric Garner case in New York City, the case involving the reputed chokehold involving the man there selling Lucy's, loose cigarettes, and also the Michael Brown case in Ferguson, Missouri, a young unarmed black teen shot to death by a police officer. What do we learn from all of this? Is there a way, is there ever going to be a time when America makes advancements, improvements in its thinking regarding race relations, regarding some kind of reconciliation between the races? Or are we going to talk race and dissension for the next 50 years? Where do we begin? W.O. Pate, let's start there.
Well, first off, anytime anybody is killed, it's unfortunate. But if somebody's trying to protect their own life or their family, and they kill someone who's trying to hurt them or harm them, that is defensible. The situation, yeah. The situation with Michael Brown. The sad part about this is that Darian Johnson, who was the individual that was with Michael Brown,
the other suspect,
made up. I had my hands up.
Was that your perspective as well? That some of the stories had been embellished, let's just say, and that some of those stories were not true, and that the grand jury made the proper decision, or what was your perspective?
Well, my perspective is that over a number of weeks after that unfortunate incident happened, and that's really who we should be hurting for, that mother and that father that lost that young man, their son. But the idea is that weeks of deliberation by the grand jury, and kudos to that district attorney for releasing all of the transcripts of the grand jury. So you had some level of transparency there. I think what we need to look at here on this issue, and what I'm looking at thinking about this issue as a state legislator, what can we do to increase the confidence in our criminal justice system?
I want to come back to that quickly. What's your perspective on it?
Okay.
Say Ferguson.
My perspective is that you have local issues and local problems, and my perspective is I've looked at law enforcement here locally, and I've personally witnessed two apprehensions in Southeast Texas over the last 90 days. And I've got to tell you that law enforcement locally, two different situations, but approached the people with professionalism, care, and respect. They didn't let things get out of hand. They were concerned about their own safety, but they were very, very professional. And my perspective is locally, we don't need to paint our local law enforcement people with the same brush. And I think if you're driving down the highway and you see an officer in uniform, I think you should wave. If you see somebody out at the mall or on the street, I think it's a good time to approach law enforcement and say thank you for your service. We do appreciate
Firstly,
it.
Firstly, are there abuses, though, in the system? And also, what is the remedy that
what we have to look at is, from the state legislative side, we have over-criminalized a lot of activities in our state. For example, we still have it on the books where we can imprison children for not going to school. I don't know if that I think that's over-criminalization. Over-criminalization, another example, 180 days, six months, Class B misdemeanor for an ounce or less of marijuana. So we have this culture of over-criminalization that really starts with our state legislature. And then we need to really sit down and have a discussion with everyone in the criminal justice team. Are there some areas that we can exercise the same transparency like that district attorney did in Missouri in releasing transcripts, especially when you have a situation where an official of the government, a law enforcement, and yes, we do respect our law enforcement, we honor them, but it's important for us as state legislators to have the institutions in place to make sure the public still has the confidence in them.
Did Wilson act properly in his case?
Just think about this. A Rasmussen poll, Kevin, said that 44% of the people polled believe that have confidence in the says that the justice system is fair. 32%, only 32% think it's fair to people of low socioeconomic means. So that's not just black and brown people. That's a lot of people across the board that think that, yes, we do need to go in and look at our criminal justice system and make sure that we have the confidence in it. Every session I've been in the legislature, 32 men come to the speaker dais that have been exonerated because of faulty evidence. So, okay, yes, we need to go back in and look at some of these issues.
All right. And we're going to have to leave it there for this week on Southeast Texas Weekly. But we had some fun, didn't we?
Always.
Yes, we did.
Absolutely. We ought to do this on a weekly basis.
Hey, that's not a bad idea.
Always good to see you again.
To see you all. And we're going to be back in just a couple of weeks on Southeast Texas Weekly to talk more politics and policy. Thanks for joining us this time. We'll see you next time.
Southeast Texas Weekly, brought to you by the Modern Vein Surgery Institute at Privity Clinic for Surgical Care.